Hey guys, it's Brandon, and welcome back to another installment of the recording series, Recreation. Because recording at home should be fun. Now today, I'd like to show you how to hook up a keyboard. So this is my KeyStation 49E made by M-Audio. It should install the drivers for you pretty easily. That's what mine did. I just plug it in and it just starts right up. You go under the audio section, MIDI devices, and then just make sure for mine, the KeyStation 49E is enabled. So two things, you're gonna wanna set your input on Reaper is in your track here, MIDI input, and then you select your keyboard, or you can do all MIDI inputs, whatever you wanna do. And then the other thing you wanna do is change your recording. So you right click your armed record track, and then you go to record MIDI overdub / replace, and then record MIDI overdub. And when you do that, it enables you to add to your tracks. This kind of stuff, I'll just kind of improv and like, oh, that sounds good, that doesn't sound good. And you know, just kind of keep building on that. And I'll show you. I've got my strings that I'm gonna be playing on much louder than the mix. That way I can hear and concentrate on that. And then, you know, I'll roll back the volume later on. Okay, so not bad. There were a few notes in there that as I played it, I was like, nah, I don't really like that, but that's okay, because we're recording MIDI. So since there were some notes that I said, nah, I didn't really like after all, let's just go ahead and go into the piano roll and fix those. There's the first one that I didn't like, so let's see what we could change that to. And I don't like this step down to that note that I've chosen now, so let's see what I might change that to. Oh yeah, how about we come up under the note? That's much better. And you know what? Let's extend this note, because I kind of like that. Let's see what it does. Change these notes, because as I was playing I didn't have much direction, so I'm gonna change these so it's different from before. And this velocity was much too high, so let's bring that down. This lead is just kind of in your face. I'm gonna lower the velocity. It's supposed to be just a backup, really. So we know what I've recorded so far actually is going to work musically. So now all I gotta do is just add to what I've already recorded, anything that might sound good. Now here is why it's good to set your recording mode to the overdub, because this way you get to add notes to this and it doesn't overwrite what you've already done, it just overdubs it. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna kinda improvise up in the high register. If I accidentally play a note that I already played and I play it at the same time, unfortunately, Philharmonic's notes stick. So if I want to, I can actually just drop the octave later, or maybe just keep what I did. Okay, that's pretty cool so far. Let's bring that down. Instead of dragging, I must just hit T and then go negative 12 semitones. Now we're down where the other ones are. Yeah. And now I feel better that I see that I could play right here and it wouldn't be a big deal. Now, it wasn't perfect timing, and in some regards, you don't want it to be because then it sounds too computer-like. Sometimes if you find yourself not quite on beat, you can just hit the Quantize button, hit Q or hit that button there. So when you hit the Quantize button, quantize all notes or selected notes. Let's just do selected notes for right now. I'll go ahead and stick, with just position and note length, and then I don't want the strength to be 100% because then it locks it into computer-like place. And so see what it's doing is it's moving my notes. I was actually playing, and it could be two things, latency and just me anticipating the notes. And also that this isn't weighted keys either, so it really doesn't help very much that's that way. So let's maybe do about 70%, hit okay. And then now they're a little bit better. Also, I don't really like the fact that I've got some loud notes. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna right click and I'm going to select, and we're just gonna kinda chop off those about right there and then pull those down. We can do it one more time and pull that down. Now the notes are a little bit more even and not, we got like loud notes all of a sudden. Let me take these notes here, maybe bring them down. Because they're kind of the steady notes. I don't want them to be too loud. These got out of time here. Let's move these over here. Okay, now if we want to, we could just go ahead and record the rest of this verse. I messed up a couple of times, but like I say, MIDI, you can change that. Let me first bring the octaves down. Now, pull it down about right there. Unintentional notes here. 16th notes. Let me also quantize these real quick, so that way they sound better. Now, the thing I'm noticing is the attack is not quite fast enough, so I think these notes do need to be a little bit ahead. So let me just drag them over. Some flub right there. That'd be easier just to re-record that section anyway. There we go. In a nutshell, that's basically how you record with a MIDI keyboard. There are definitely more episodes coming for this recording series, Recreation. And as always, if you have any comments, questions, just leave those below, and I'll definitely get back with you and help you any way I can. And if you haven't already, please consider subscribing because I do post every Wednesday and Saturday. And so if you have any questions for our future Q&A, please leave those below, and we will add that to our next Q&A. And beyond that, I do look forward to continuing connecting with you guys on Wednesdays and Saturdays. I look forward to teaching you all that I know in this place that I've created for melodic metal guitarists. Thank you guys, and I'll see you next time.